what we hate more than scams? Overpriced miracle cures aimed at our most vulnerable.
And it seems that some companies will do anything to get a sale, promising the world and coming up with, well, less than the world.
Yes, we think it's time for a crackdown on this behaviour. Hannah gets the ball rolling.
What an odd sensation.
It's unusual.
Being buzzed?
Being buzzed, yeah.
Yeah, and almost like electricity goes through your spine, really.
For most people, massage is a luxury, so you might expect that a do-it-yourself kit like this one...
Feels like a phone on vibrate that's gone, like, hyperactive.
...would save you a dollar or two.
I don't know, $50?
Maybe $150 to $100 altogeter.
$100?
By now, you'll have guessed this isn't a cheap piece of kit. It retails for...
$4,000. Wow.
$4,000.
Oh, my God, this is ridiculous.
Yep, that's pretty steep for what looks like a pulsating cushion and a vibrating massage wand.
But, you know, when you're desperate, when you're in terrible pain, you might be persuaded that these are the answer to your prayers.
Excruciating pain. Really painful. And it just didn't stop. No matter what you've done.
Around Christmas time last year, Bob Armstrong and his daughter Angela were feeling desperate about Bob's state of health.
My dad has complete renal failure, so he's got dialysis 3 times a week. He's had little to no circulation in his feet.
How bad were your feet?
They'd gone past red, they were going to purple and heading towards black.
He was talking to the renal doctors at Middlemore and they were saying that there was a very real chance they'd have to be amputated in order to deal with the pain that he was in. Dad was terrified by the prospect of having his feet amputated.
Not quite right, I don't think.
And that was the state Bob was in when, a few days before Christmas, Gulf Harbour Healthcare's Northern Regional Manager, Stuart Hintz, arrived with this very massage set.
Oh, he went on and asked questions about you and the house and the section and just went on and made a big friend of himself. He was your good friend in that.
What questions did he ask you about your health? What did you tell him about your health?
I just told him my feet were bugged, you know.
Bob says the salesman convinced him that the massage set would really help with his pain and his circulation. He paid in full on the spot $4,000.
He was extremely desperate. He was staring down the barrel of amputation.
If you're in pain like that, there's a light, little bit of light at the end of the tunnel, you'll do anything. You will.
That sale took place on December 18. Then Bob was away with his family through Christmas and New Year. And on January 3rd, Bob was admitted to hospital for major surgery. 2 operations which restored the blood flow to his feet and legs, saving his feet and changing his life.
How are your feet now?
Well, they're coming right. They're coming really good.
But it was only when Bob was in hospital and his family were looking after his finances that they came across the $4,000 credit card payment for the massage gear.
We were incredibly angry that this had happened, that we really felt like he'd been preyed on at a time where he was extremely vulnerable, and that they'd come in selling a ridiculously overpriced product to a man who was looking for a miracle cure.
I'm thinking I'm a gullible idiot. That's what I think.
Gulf Harbour Healthcare told the family that Bob could have returned the product shortly after the sale, but didn't. They say they phoned to make sure Bob was happy, and since it was several months before the family asked for the refund, too late. No refund. The family said you shouldn't have sold him the product in the first place.
It doesn't work. It wouldn't work for someone with serious circulation problems.
Do you think this product would ever have done you any good?
No show in hell. Not a show in hell.
And it hurt.
It's quite a sharp vibration. When your toes and feet are that sensitive, it's all right.
If this whole saga sounds a bit familiar, back in 2002, Thergo featured an Australian company called Niagara, selling a very similar product.
Then he was shown a pad for his back that vibrated and heated up, and a round tube that vibrated to help with his feet.
Well, how much was it?
$3,588.
The then New Zealand manager for Niagara, Stephen Orton, is now the co-owner of Gulf Harbour Healthcare. Niagara was the subject of complaints over its therapeutic claims and suggestions that it was targeting the elderly.
I think he was predatory on an old person on her own.
We wanted an expert opinion on the massage set, and you don't get much experter than physiotherapy professor Duncan Reed.
It's an enormous amount of money for what looked like two fairly simple pieces of equipment.
Professor Reed checked out the claims made in the sales brochure.
Here's this person. She's using it under her armpit, which seems a little bit unusual to me.
There's a list of problems which the massager claims to help.
Increased blood circulation, sore and aching muscles, increased joint mobility. These are treating or giving you the impression they're treating a problem when in fact they're treating the symptom.
Professor Reed says the best treatment for circulation problems is exercise.
If you truly want to improve the circulation, yeah, you've got to make your heart rate go up.
Yeah.
This thing's making your heart rate go down, which is perfect if you want to relax.
Okay, so it's relaxation, yes.
Yep.
Actually changing a serious medical condition for the better.
Not likely, no.
Bob's serious circulation problems meant the massager would in fact cause more pain.
When those nerves are not normal, the body perceives this as more harmful and sends more discomfort back to the brain to say this is a really unpleasant situation.
And Bob says the salesman didn't actually see the state of his feet or test the equipment on them.
It's not good for that person to be selling a product when they haven't looked at the area that it might be used on. That's a dangerous place to be, isn't it? Because they're not truly taking a holistic look at this person. They're more interested in selling the product.
Gulf Harbour Healthcare have always absolutely backed their product and the sale, but they didn't want to do that on camera.
They say Bob didn't tell the salesman how serious his medical condition was, only that he was on dialysis, and they say they've got a lot of happy customers on dialysis. Bob was specifically told it wasn't a miracle cure. Bob could have returned the product soon after the sale, but didn't. As to the massage being too painful, they say Bob was told to call them if there were any problems, and he didn't.
And the company says that under consumer law, they don't have to refund Bob, so they're not going to.
It's just a waste of time. Absolute waste of time. It wasn't doing any good, and it did hurt.
Whoa.
You know, I watched that and it just makes me sad. And I think the law is there to protect consumers. It is also there to protect businesses, but businesses also have a moral obligation, surely.
I'd like to add some of those thoughts, but the lawyers say that my thoughts don't actually make the threshold for legal, so I've got to just zip.
Yeah, so keep it quiet there. Yeah. Look, next week we're going to have more on this issue, focusing on how younger people can look after their parents and grandparents so they avoid getting into similar sticky situations.
That machine was $4,000.
Keep reading.
Okay.